Hello and welcome. Thank you for joining us. I'm Jacqueline Matter in for Scott Dennis. Topping our news this afternoon, fire officials in Palmetto are investigating a warehouse that went up in flames this morning. Now investigators say they believe that fire was arson to cover up a break-in. ABC 7's Dwayne Lindo joins us live from Palmetto with the very latest on that investigation. Dwayne.
Well, Jackie, good afternoon. Firefighters fighting flames all morning. And as you can see behind me, the structure sustained some heavy damage. The fire started around 7:30, around 7:45, around that time, and was quickly upgraded to a second alarm fire. Bradenton officials also helped out. The building is just used as a storage unit containing car parts and tires, which is why some folks out here saw some black smoke. Burning rubber also has that distinct smell that witnesses talked about. The roof and walls have collapsed. The structure was just about destroyed. One witness says the building has been there since the 1920s and used to be a church. No other buildings were affected and no one was hurt. But the fire officials say the tires pose as a problem trying to put the fire out.
Yep, the tires, they burn extremely hot. It actually becomes more of a petroleum, a fuel-based fire, you know, like a tanker incident on the side of the road. Those tires, we have to use a lot of foam. We actually use about 30 gallons of foam to help suppress that fire. And we also had a boat exposure, and the boat's fiberglass and stuff like that. That fiberglass burns extremely hot as well.
Now, Palmetto PD is considering this to be arson, and they are talking to one suspect. We will have more for you later on in the newscast. Jackie, back to you.
All right, thanks so much, Dwayne. We'll continue to keep you updated on that fire on air and online at mysuncoast.com. The Northport Police Department is asking for your help identifying a man wanted for armed robbery. Police say he walked into the discount tobacco and beer store with a semi-automatic handgun, demanded money from a shopper and clerk, then drove off in what detectives believe to be a white Cadillac with large rims. No one was injured in that robbery, but if you have any information on this case or if you recognize the man in that photo, you are asked to contact Manatee County Crime Stoppers at the number listed on your screen. The Florida Highway Patrol will hold a DUI sting tonight. Operation Wolfpack will aim at getting impaired drivers off the streets and will focus primarily on I-75 and other major state and county roadways. It'll take place in DeSoto, Hardy, Highlands, Sarasota, and Manatee counties from 9 o'clock tonight to 5 tomorrow morning. A proposed housing and commercial development that has been stirring up lots of heated debate takes another big step forward. Manatee County Planning Commissioners voted 3-2 in favor of that massive development, which would be built in the Long Bar Point area between Elkhorn Conquistador Parkway and Sarasota Bay. The development would feature nearly 2,900 residences and 78,000 square feet of commercial space. It's getting a lot of mixed reaction, mainly because of environmental concerns as well as height concerns of some of the buildings.
The idea of this, especially this lagoon that they're looking to build along the shoreline, we're not sure about the flushing abilities and if it won't have negative impacts. Rather, we'd rather see the shoreline maintained the way it is.
Almost 3,000 homes, 3,000 residences. That's a lot of employment for a lot of people over a very long time. And once it's built, then there are things like remodeling and refurbishing. And people who live there, they're going to shop in the grocery stores.
Well, that development now heads to Manatee County Commissioners for approval on May 4th. Certainly a beautiful weekend shaping up, John.
Yeah, I think so. Pretty nice. A lot of sunshine out there. As you mentioned earlier, yes, though, I believe you, if you're going to the beach, you should take a sunscreen because the UV index is, you know, even at this time of year, they're pretty high. You can get a little bit
of
a burn.
Record temperatures as well as what you've mentioned over the past couple days.
Very warm temperatures across the region. Record because in the last year, every month has been above average.
Hmm.
And it looks like we're right on track that this month also will be above average.
Interesting.
It is interesting, isn't it? We have a lot of blue sky out there right now. KCQ webcam showing that beautiful blue sky and a few fair weather clouds as well, but none of those clouds are really going to be rain producers today. We are looking at pretty quiet conditions across the board from north to south across the entire viewing area. Radar showing how dry it is across the state. And of course, those drought indexes continue to rise. The most of central Florida and south central Florida now in a drought, as classified by the U.S. Drought Monitor, which keeps track of these sort of things across the U.S. As far as our weather goes, you know, a few fair weather clouds, but really that's about it. And a lot more sunshine than anything else. Maybe a couple of those clouds around the mouth of Charlotte Harbor might produce a sprinkle a little bit later on, but that's really about it. Daytime high today tops out warm at about 85. And you can expect to see the winds increase a little bit in the second half of the day, but otherwise just gorgeous. Complete forecast coming up in a few. Back to you, Jacqueline.
All right, thanks, John. We will check back in with you in here a few minutes. Well, the Ringling Art Museum is receiving a big donation from two major philanthropists. A donation of $400,000 will go towards creating a new glass pavilion. Longtime supporters Charlotte and Charles Perret and Willis Smith Construction are the ones who donated the money. Opening in the fall of 2017, that pavilion will not only house the Ringling's growing collection of studio glass, but also serve as the formal entrance to the historic Oslo Theater. In addition, the Ringling will be able to expand and enhance the art of performance programming. In honor of this grand donation, the new box office will be named the Willis A. Smith Construction Ticket Desk. Well, a tradition that's been on the Suncoast for over two decades continued today in Sarasota. Hundreds of people gathered at the Hollywood 20 on Main Street this morning for the Church of the Redeemer's annual Stations of the Cross Good Friday walk. They walked from the movie theater to the church on Palm Avenue, where they held a prayer service, picking up more and more participants all along the way.
Mainly, it's almost always a positive reaction. Some people stop what they're doing and say a prayer, make the sign of the cross. Some people actually join us as we go, and it's always respectful.
The church has been putting on that walk in observance of the Passion of Jesus Christ for 21 years. Meanwhile, children in Palmetto took to the streets this morning in celebration as well. The annual DeSoto Children's Parade kicked off, bringing kids of all ages out to take part. The walking parade took place in downtown Palmetto off of 8th Avenue all the way to Sutton Park. Local elementary schools, sports teams, and organizations participated. Now, that parade is a smaller version of the DeSoto Parade, but it's geared for kids.
I think it's a really great time for families to come in a really fun atmosphere that's safe for us. I know I'm bringing my girls today. We usually do participate and walk in the parade, but I think it's just really family friendly.
Well, that certainly looks like a fun time this morning. Different organizations entered floats into that parade to be judged. Now, the winner of that contest will get the opportunity to ride their float in the DeSoto Night Parade. Well, it is about lunchtime, so time now to head out to ABC 7 Culinary Director Judy Gallagher, who is live at Selby Gardens at their French food truck.
Well, bonjour to all. I can't think of a better place to be on Easter weekend. You know, the Marc Chagall exhibit is going on. The orchids and the flowers are in full bloom. The humidity is not so bad. This is the perfect time to come out and support our local gardens. But what I'm so excited about is leave it to Michael's on East to be this creative, to come up with a food truck, the French term we will let Michael say, but it is known as the bread box, and you'll get to see a variety of the foods that they're serving at a remarkable price. Take a step back into time, enjoy the gardens and the Chagall exhibit, have some champagne and some delicious food, and stay with me throughout the hour. We have crepes, we have baguettes, we have so much wonderful cuisine, and some great information about Selby Gardens tours. I'll be here throughout the hour bringing you some magnificent food, so stay with me. It's going to be a delicious afternoon. I'll be back in just a few minutes.
My Hometown Fest is coming to Nathan Benderson Park Saturday, April 15th. Join us for culinary favorites from across the U.S. paired with your favorite craft beers. There's also great live music and activities for adults and kids. Buy your tickets today at myhometownfest.org.
The official Suncoast Storm Team at ABC 7. We're here for you.
Let me introduce you to the ultimate Florida window. Do you feel safer with this or this? You'll be proud too.
This Saturday only, save 40% off factory direct windows. Bring in your measurements for on-the-spot pricing. So many times we underestimate the human spirit's drive to recover. We often see people surpass what any of us might have expected initially. The Rehabilitation Pavilion at Sarasota Memorial is the top of the line. It allows us to really bring the patient's recovery to the next level.
Everyone is looking for carpeting that lasts longer. G. Fried has you covered with Karastan. With a legacy of quality and integrity, we provide you with a huge selection of Karastan carpets with exclusive lifetime limited warranties. All installed by our highly skilled, highly knowledgeable team. Come ask us why Karastan is the best and most durable. G. Fried Flooring America. Our world is at your feet.
Tickets are going fast for My Hometown Fest, being held from noon till 5 p.m. Saturday, April 15th at Nathan Benderson Park. Enjoy foods from 40 area restaurants, 60-plus craft beers, live music, and lots of fun. Buy your tickets today at myhometownfest.org.
Now, the official Suncoast weather with ABC 7 meteorologist John Scalzi.
Another warm one here on the Sun Coast. Current air temperature 80 degrees with plenty of sunshine out there. Only a few fair weather clouds. The dew point value, though, still low. Feels great. 53 degrees. That's nice. Any dew points in the 50s feels good. And I don't think we're going to see dew points in the 60s till now, probably next week. Probably midweek next week. Mid-60s, I should say. We may even see the dew points dip a little bit as we head into Saturday into Sunday. I love that. It feels really great out there. Despite the fact that the temperatures are above average and warm, those low dew point values make it feel pretty comfortable. Air conditioners don't have to work quite as hard if you're running your AC. East wind coming in at about 9. Those winds will surge later this afternoon. We've got 78 degrees, Wauchula 79, Arcadia, same thing in Myakka, Parrish, Ditto at 79, Bradenton at 79. Lakewood Ranch comes in at 78, 79 in Venice, Inglewood at 77, 75 degrees in Northport, and Punta Gorda comes in at 82. We have a 75 at Longboat Key as well. So quiet across the region, but we are now down 7 inches of rainfall. So we really, really are dry around the region. And as I mentioned yesterday, the U.S. drought, or even a few minutes ago, the U.S. drought monitor has identified much of central and southern Florida as being in a drought situation. So the fire danger indexes continue to rise. And I just mentioned this again, as we head into a holiday weekend, there'll be a lot of barbecue grills going, I bet you. So just let's be extra careful with fire, particularly in Manatee County, identified as a very high risk for fire danger currently. Not a lot of rainfall in the forecast for today. Now, yesterday we had a little brief sprinkle around the mouth of Charlotte Harbor. Didn't really add much to the rainfall bucket. And if we get anything again today, I don't think it will either. There is a chance at a passing brief quick shower, but most likely it'll be out in Gulf waters because we have a strong easterly wind surge anticipated. Traveling today, well, the deep south looks good. Nothing here that concerns us. Atlanta airports, Raleigh, Durham, Charlotte airport all look fine. Even back to the west, the airports of Dallas and Houston look okay. Now, in the center part of the country, we do have some stronger storms brewing. And in fact, it's there where we might find ourselves with some severe weather a little bit later on. Also in extreme western parts of Texas, and particularly in the Top Hat. Otherwise, you know, some standard thunderstorm activity around the Atlanta airport and around the Charlotte airport are possible, but this is standard. It's not severe, should be fine, and across the state of Florida will be dry. So the reason we're dry is this big ridge of high pressure that is now settling in response to developing low pressure areas back to the west. As those lows continue to drift in the northern tier, this high is pushed into the Atlantic and pushed south. That twists our winds to the east and sets up a situation where those winds are really funneled across the peninsula, so the winds will be picking up. If you are traveling this weekend to the other coast, pay attention to lifeguard flags because there will be a rip current problem. There will be a small craft advisory if you're boating or engaging in water sports. Could be an issue over there. Not so much for us, though we will have to watch those afternoon wind speeds both this evening and tomorrow evening as well. We may get an exercise caution statement from the Weather Service. Otherwise, beautiful Easter. The week ahead looks nice. Maybe a chance of rain Thursday. Let's hope so anyway. Back to you.
In your health news today, it's truly a life and death decision. Now new evidence shows that some strategies to quit smoking may be better than others. As fewer and fewer of us smoke, many Americans who do smoke want desperately to quit. But how exactly are they doing it? Well, researchers at the CDC wanted to know, so they asked more than 16,000 smokers, and most used multiple methods to kick their habit. The most popular methods, quitting cold turkey and substituting e-cigarettes for some or all of the tobacco versions. A reminder that these new devices have yet to prove themselves as a viable way to stop smoking, and no studies have shown they help smokers quit. There are so many different recommendations when it comes to breast cancer screenings, it can obviously get a bit confusing. According to a new survey, many primary care physicians and gynecologists are still recommending breast cancer screenings for women between the ages of 40 and 44. However, health organizations remain divided on when women should begin regular mammograms. Some organizations argue early screening helps with early detection, while opponents of it say it more likely to lead to overdiagnosis and false positive results. Well, aspirin can be an effective pain reliever, but new research has found another potentially life-saving use for that drug. Researchers at Harvard found that regular doses of aspirin may reduce the risk of dying from cancer. In a study of 100,000 people, men who took aspirin regularly had a 15% lower cancer mortality risk than those who did not. For women, it was 7% lower. Researchers believe aspirin may help reduce the risk of death for men with prostate and lung cancer, while the drug may help fend off death from breast cancer for women. Previous studies have also found that aspirin can help patients at risk for heart attack or stroke. Well, still ahead, a local animal shelter taking a unique spin on how to raise money, how you and your pet can get involved.
Check out My Suncoast Dining on MySuncoast.com for Chef Judy's favorite recipes, restaurant guide, and more. Go to MySuncoast.com/dining.
Are you considering joint replacement or revision surgery? Consider this. Dr. Edward Stolarski has performed thousands of successful joint replacement procedures and trained surgeons from all over the world. Using advanced technologies, Dr. Stolarski is able to perform some of the most complex surgeries.
I wish I knew about Dr. Stolarski much sooner.
After the surgery, I don't have any pain. It's like I've got a 16-year-old hip.
My name's Ed Stolarski. What I really do is I give people back their life.
Schedule a consultation today.
What to do when your heating or air conditioning needs service or, heaven forbid, replacement? Call Air Now today. We've been serving Sarasota and Manatee counties since 1946. We offer $49.95 tune-ups, lease or finance options, and remember, service today or it's free.
Is your old garage door stuck or broken? Would a new one give you a lift? Let Precision Door Overhead Garage Door Service of Sarasota come to the rescue with prompt and affordable repair service. Replacement doors come with an array of styles and colors, and they are rated to meet and exceed Florida standards. From estimates to installation, your satisfaction is our priority. If you're not 100% satisfied with any product, service, or installation, we will make it right, because Precision Door Service is a name you can trust.
Are you Goodwill?
Yes, because when I donate
or shop at Goodwill,
I'm creating a job.
I am Goodwill, yeah, yeah.
Ace is the place with the helpful hardware, folks.
My yard, it's overgrown, it's out of control, it's a huge problem.
I showed Randy our entire line of outdoor power equipment. We have everything he needs.
Ace is the place that lets you clear land like a modern-day pioneer. Yeah!
Don't miss these April Red Hot Buys. Six convenient Sarasota locations and now open in Bradenton, Northport, and soon Osprey. It's the season of savings right now during the spring clearance event at Sunset Dodge, Chrysler Jeep Ram in Sarasota. Over 100 standard and available safety features make the new Chrysler Pacifica a safe investment for any family.
And right now, you can own one for just $24,999. Or get one of America's longest-lasting pickups and save up to $11,000 on a new Ram Crew Cab. Better prices, bigger selection. Go to Sunset Dodge Chrysler Jeep Ram in Sarasota.
Welcome back. It is 12:20 on this Friday. Well, each Friday during the noon show, ABC 7 will be sharing a pet or pets with you that need a family. These pets come from local animal shelters right here on the Suncoast. And joining us this afternoon is the founder of Dante's Den and host of Animal Outtakes, Marsha Panucci.
We have a beautiful little kitty here, Marsha. Who is this little fella?
Well, it's a very handsome young man named Virgil.
Virgil. Yeah.
And Virgil is very, very, very special. And why? Because he is a senior citizen. He's about 15 years young. And
okay.
You know, that is young for a cat.
Yeah.
It truly
Young-ish.
Is. Yeah, whatever.
Yeah.
But he is just a wonderful, wonderful little guy who loves to be loved, who loves to be carried, who loves to be cuddled, and you found the right ear.
Oh, John. He does love to be. Oh, he's a lap cat,
yes,
you can tell.
Yes, he is a lap
yes,
cat.
Yes, you are, Virgil.
Yes,
he is. Oh, it feels so good.
He'd like to go home today if he would guarantee him to be loved and cuddled like this.
Oh, what,
yes,
honey?
Yes.
What? You like that? Is that
yeah.
a good place?
Okay. He has the most gorgeous green eyes, greenish gold.
Yeah, it does.
And he is a tabby.
Any health issues that we know of?
We have a few.
Minor.
We don't have major ones, but we do have a little bit of a heart murmur. But then again, we all kind of get that
don't
from
we all?
Time to time. But certainly, he is full of love. He loves to ride in cars. He loves to watch television with you, and he is just. Yes.
Oh, sweetie,
well, he would.
Good?
You
is
would never
good?
Know that he was 15. Absolutely.
Oh, he's a
never
talker.
Know. Yes. He. Yes. He's.
Yeah.
He's chatting with you. He's not particularly happy with the cameras, but beyond that, he is just absolutely gorgeous.
What a sweetie.
So he does need a special home, and he probably has many wonderful years left. Look at that face.
Oh,
that is
beautiful.
Not the face of an older cat. That
yeah.
is the face of probably a middle-aged cat.
Okay.
And he just, he's
right,
just
sweetie.
Talking. He's just
okay.
talking.
All
and
right.
of course,
he's had it here.
Yeah,
he
wants to go.
He's ready to move on.
Yes, he wants
yeah.
to go to lunch, I'm sure.
I don't blame you, sweetie.
So you just have to call Cat Depot, John.
Okay.
And you know,
the number I think we have on our screen there, I believe.
There we go.
Cat Depot, 366-2404. Give him a call, and this will be an absolutely beautiful addition to your home. So.
And Virgil's
you,
looking
Marcia.
To come home.
Yeah,
thanks,
this is
John.
Sweetheart. You're a sweet kitty. Back to you.
All right, Don. I think he likes you petting him on his ear. Well, if you're a pet lover, then having a photo shoot for your furry friend sounds totally acceptable, right? Well, tomorrow, the Humane Society of Sarasota County will be holding a photo shoot fundraiser from 9 a.m. to noon at Buddy Brew Coffee on Palm Avenue in downtown Sarasota. You can book a photo shoot for your pet for just $35, and 100% of those proceeds will go right back to the Humane Society. Well, it's time now to head back over to Selby Gardens and check in with ABC 7 Culinary Director Judy Gallagher.
Well, hi there. It is the gorgeous day that we were hoping for, and I want you to meet Misha Kirby, who's the marketing director here at Selby Gardens, and is going to share with us what's happening and the inspiration for the French food truck and so much more.
Thanks, Judy. Well, you know, you're not in Sarasota. You're really in the French Riviera while
That's
you're
right.
here.
I forgot that.
So we have an exhibit that's going on, Marc Chagall Flowers in the French Riviera, The Color of Dreams. And so the whole of Selby Gardens has been transformed into this idea of the South of France. And so you come here and you see the plants that are in bloom, and we've made lavender fields that overlook Sarasota Bay. And then we have some masterpiece artwork and archival photos of Marc Chagall. And those are in our Museum of Botany and the Arts. And so once you've made this nice leisurely walk through the French Riviera, you come out and you come here, and you're in the mood to be completely immersed in the South of France.
And it literally is. I mean, leave it to Michael Zanis to have a food truck that's so going to deliver whether you want to sip a champagne or just a cool iced tea and some wonderful cuisine. Now, there's a lot more that's happening at Selby Gardens as well. Let's talk about Easter weekend.
Yeah, so this Sunday we're having Easter brunch. And that takes place in Michael's on the Bay that overlooks the bayfront right there with the Ringling Bridge soaring. So you can come enjoy Easter brunch. We'll have Mother's Day as well.
That's right. That'll be the next
There's
holiday.
There's another reason to come. And then we actually have a concert Sunday afternoon from 1 to 3. The Black Honkies from Tampa Bay, they'll be here performing on the Banyans, under the Banyans.
It's going to be such a beautiful experience. Now let's talk a little bit more about, besides the food truck, the French food truck right here, you also have another restaurant that's available for people. And we just mentioned Easter. What else can people expect to make it a day at Selby Gardens?
Well, that's the nice thing about Selby, is you really can sink in, relax. You can put away your phone, unless you want to take pictures. But you kind of just take the garden path, and you walk and you enjoy. We have the children's rainforest garden, so the kids can play. We have the historic home of Marie Selby, and that also has the cafe by Michael's on East in there. And we have a slightly different expanded menu there as well. And of course the museum. We have classes that are always ongoing, so if someone's interested in painting or learning how to repot an orchid or something like that, we have hundreds of classes.
I actually took a course once on my earth boxes, and it worked out fabulously. I have a great salsa earth box that I learned from Selby Gardens. So much to learn. You're doing amazing things, and stay with me. I am on the French Riviera today, and it is all happening right at Selby Gardens. We'll be back in a few minutes to talk about the inspiration behind the cuisine, the actual dishes, and Michael Klauber will be at the helm. We'll be back in just a few minutes for some more deliciousness. Hi, I'm Chef Judy. Every Wednesday morning, I'll be with the chefs at the Publix Aprons Cooking School serving up the most wonderful dishes. Watch Aprons in the Kitchen every Wednesday on ABC7's Good Morning Suncoast.
They're coming from Tampa, Fort Myers, even Orlando. They're coming from everywhere for the Sarasota Ford Promise. We promise we're more than a dealership. We're a destination with a movie theater, massage room, aquarium, cafe, and more. We promise to give you top dollar for your trade, even if you don't buy from us. And if you do, we promise you the best deal. Bring us any competitor's ad, and we'll beat it by at least $1,000. That's why they're coming from everywhere to Sarasota Ford, where 41 meets 301. SarasotaFord.com.
I knew I could get myself out of this. I just needed some hope and some help.
I took the first step to recovery when I made the call.
Since 2014, Addiction Hope and Helpline has answered calls for recovery and treatment 24/7, 365 days a year. If you're depressed, drinking, using drugs, or taking pills, call now and talk to someone who cares.
I had problems just getting to sleep, drinking and using pills every night.
I feel like I'm losing control. I'm afraid I'll lose my job or even my family.
Most insurance covers substance abuse. You can get back on track. Call now for hope and help with proven gentle recovery programs.
I never thought that I could be somebody who didn't drink and use drugs.
I have something to hold on to for strength. I'm in recovery, getting the help I need.
Call 800-622-1941. 800-622-1941.
During the past 10 years, Tidewell Hospice volunteers have provided more than 1 million hours of service. They sit with patients, giving caregivers a break. They work in offices. They take their furry friends on pet therapy visits. They even clown around. Every task performed by a volunteer makes a difference in the lives of our patients and their families. Join Tidewell's volunteer team. They're truly one in a million. Tidewell Hospice, it's more than you think.
There are many choices when it comes to AC companies. Our advice? Choose a company that performs employee background checks and is licensed with top manufacturers like Daikin. Daikin offers a 12-year parts and labor limited warranty. For better comfort and value, call Elite Heating and Air.
Need more space in your place? The More Space Place can help. With Murphy beds that disappear to reveal a home office, living room, or den. Custom closets with designated areas for your shoes, bags, wardrobe, and accessories. Custom-built entertainment centers, garage storage systems, and more. The More Space Place has three showrooms. Next to Sonny's on US 41 South in Sarasota, on Lakewood Ranch Boulevard just south of State Route 64 in Bradenton, and on Tamiami Trail next to Panera Bread in Port Charlotte. Put more space in your place at the More Space Place.
Live from our studios on Florida's Sun Coast, this is ABC 7 News at Noon. Your Suncoast News. We're here for you.
Welcome back. It is 12:29 on this Friday. It's been 1 week since President Trump ordered a missile strike on Syria. Now all eyes are on North Korea ahead of a possible nuclear weapons test as the world is still reacting to the U.S. dropping the mother of all bombs in eastern Afghanistan. ABC's Janae Norman is following the very latest developments in Washington.
This is the bomb the U.S. used for maximizing the destruction of ISIS, and according to Afghan officials, killed 36 ISIS fighters.
The weapon achieved its intended purpose.
It's called a massive ordnance air blast, but nicknamed the mother of all bombs. It weighs 22,000 pounds and is the largest non-nuclear bomb the U.S. has ever dropped in combat. The intended target, a series of cave complexes used by ISIS in eastern Afghanistan.
Here we had these fighters were down in this deep valley. This is really rugged terrain, and so the blast was focused and pushed up into the caves to take out these fighters.
This new video shows just how massive that bomb is. So large, it has to be carried and pushed out the back of a C-130 cargo plane, tethered to a parachute before striking its target. A massive show of force, and not just to ISIS, but also other U.S. enemies.
We watch North Korea here. Was that heard on the other side of the world in Pyongyang, and will it make an impression on Kim Jong-un?
Recent satellite images show a North Korean nuclear test site primed and ready for a launch expected Saturday. Top U.S. military leaders say the increasing pace of missile tests there over the past 6 months have made the situation urgent, leading the U.S. to move an aircraft carrier strike group into position.
I don't know if this sends a message. It doesn't make any difference if it does or not. North Korea is a problem. The problem will be taken care of.
Earlier this week, President Trump sent a series of tweets calling North Korea a problem that's looking for trouble. One North Korean official says Washington has become more vicious and more aggressive since Trump took office. Janae Norman, ABC News, Washington.
Well, the investigation continues into what's being called a misdirected coalition airstrike that killed 18 allies in Syria. The incident happened Tuesday near the ISIS stronghold city of Raqqa. U.S. officials say the coalition airstrike killed members of the Syrian Democratic Forces. Now, that's an opposition group supported by the United States in the fight against ISIS. The U.S. military says the target they hit was wrongly identified as being ISIS. Beautiful weather shaping up for the Easter weekend. Great day to head out to the beach if you have Good Friday off.
Yeah, I really think it will be. I think there'll be just enough cloud cover out there tonight around sunset that the colors of the sky will be really pretty.
Oh, so a nice sunset shaping
up. I think so.
Oh, good to hear.
Yeah, it might be a little windy. Might be a little breezy. The winds are going to be picking up during the second half of the day. And if you're a boater, I don't want you to be caught by surprise by that, because that's going to happen for a couple of days in a row. I think we'll see those winds. Maybe as high as 20 knots out there on open waters during the evening hours. Beautiful shot from the Van Wezel webcam showing a nice blue sky out there over our Gulf waters. Absolutely a spectacular day as far as the forecast for the rest of the afternoon goes. Just these fair weather clouds that are beginning to pop up here on high resolution satellite. Look for a daytime high that tops out near the 85 degree mark, slightly above average as we are getting accustomed to. And then over the weekend, I think the beautiful weather will continue, and we'll detail that forecast for you in just a few. Back to you.
All right, thanks, John. We will check back in with you shortly. The Wisconsin man suspected of robbing a gun store and sending President Trump a disturbing manifesto has been captured. Joseph Jakubowski captured this morning after an intense 10-day search. Now, he's accused of stealing 18 guns from a store before burning up his car and then sending a threatening 161-page manifesto to President Trump, claiming that the government is a gang of terrorists. The threat intensified when investigators looked into a separate letter mailed by someone claiming to be Jakubowski. It was directed at unspecified churches in the Milwaukee area, threatening unspecified violence on Easter Sunday.
The number of weapons he took, we feel that he is posing a threat.
Police say that man was taken into custody on a farm without incident, more than 2 hours away from the gun store. Police at airports in New York City are taking a hands-off approach when it comes to removing passengers from overbooked flights. Port Authority of New York and New Jersey Police Superintendent Michael Fedorko issued a new policy after a passenger was dragged from an oversold United Airlines flight Sunday evening at Chicago's O'Hare International Airport. The policy says officers will not assist in the physical removal of passengers to accommodate the airline's request. Officers are to examine each instance on a case-by-case basis. A fun spring break trip for one family to Six Flags turned terrifying after a ride on the Joker's Jinx. Two dozen people were trapped for nearly 4 hours on the ride at Six Flags America in Maryland on Thursday. 10 passengers were brought down in a cherry picker after hours of waiting, while others were brought down about an hour later. Those stuck on the ride describe what happened.
It was going at like normal speed, and then you just heard the noise, and then it just like was just like stopped.
Now this video is of them being rescued after being stuck for 2 hours. While they were stuck, the mom and dad could only wait. Javier Valverde's father says you can see the kids up there and you can't help them. Meanwhile, there is more details continuing to wait as we continue to figure out what happens with this incident. Well, let's head over to our ABC 7 culinary chef, Judy Gallagher, who is at Selby Gardens.
Michael Klauber is here. Bonjour.
Bonjour, Judy. Ça va? Ça va bien?
You need a beret. That's all you need, Michael. This
Absolument.
Is so wonderful. Describe to us this array of great French cuisine.
En français ou anglais?
Let's do anglais.
Okay, so we were inspired by the whole Marc Chagall exhibit and the whole concept here at Selby Gardens to do the five senses, and so part of that is the food side of it. So we've gone and really thought out all the things that when we travel to Provence and we're in the French Riviera, what are some of the things that we would eat? So we've created this menu out of our brand new food truck here.
Which I love.
La boîte à pain, which means the bread box. So it's very traditional, fun French dishes. Of course, we have a niçoise, but a really beautiful niçoise from Chef Jamil. We've got a great, we've got some different crepes that we do. We've got a savory crepe. We've got, you'll see later, you've got a sweet crepe. We've got a wonderful vegetarian crepe, a French saucisson sandwich with beautiful peppers, a croque-monsieur sandwich, and the wonderful bread with the nuts and the chocolate in it. So,
I don't know why there's a slight piece missing out of it,
well,
but I think maybe one of our
assistants. Won't hold that against you, Judy.
That's
the whole idea was take people away with everything they've done in the garden here, with the landscaping, with the facilities. We really wanted people to feel like they could step into Marc Chagall's world.
And they have, and you're even offering champagne.
We've got a great little package. They can come in and get a bottle of champagne, the niçoise salad, one of the beautiful French desserts that we offer, and have a wonderful picnic here on the grounds.
It is so lovely. I highly recommend it till July, correct?
Till July, yes.
So let's talk quickly about Easter Sunday, because I know you still have a few reservations open.
Well, you know, this is the first Easter brunch in our brand new Michael's on the Bay Ballroom.
I mean, it's beautiful.
The
what you've
view
done
is incredible.
Amazing.
Great Easter egg hunt. The Easter Bunny will be there, and it's going to be a beautiful buffet. It's a great opportunity. I don't think people know that we're here yet. So, you know, we're very excited. Brand new facility, gorgeous views of the bay. It's air conditioned, and the kids will have a blast with the Easter Bunny and the Easter egg hunt that's going to go here.
What are the hours for brunch? And then let's get back to the hours of the food.
We take reservations from 10 o'clock till 2 p.m.
Great.
So, you know, all those times in between, but it's going to be a great day. As you know,
really
Phil and
is.
I love doing our Easter brunches, so
I know,
it's a big
so
deal.
It's so special. And the hours that the French food truck is available?
The food truck is open daily from 11 to 4, kind of coincides with the beautiful Chagall exhibit that's going on. But yeah, it's been so fun with the food truck. It's our first, of course, and we look forward to doing a lot of really fun things with it in the future.
Me too. And we'll be back in just a few moments with something a little sweet to end up our day.
Bon appetit.
Bon appetit.
For your plumbing, electrical, or air conditioning, and services is qualified, and service calls are free. And services.com. A-N-D services.com.
ABC 7, your Suncoast News. We're here for you weeknights at 5. Don't miss Southwest Florida's largest barbecue and bluegrass event Friday, April 14th and Saturday, April 15th, when the 8th annual Suncoast Barbecue and Bluegrass Bash returns to Venice. Bring the whole family and enjoy genuine competition barbecue and award-winning bluegrass entertainment. Please join us for a finger-licking and hot-picking good time April 14th and 15th at the Suncoast Barbecue and Bluegrass Bash. Free admission, parking, entertainment, and family activities. Get all the details at suncoastbarbecuebash.com.
Why settle for less? Get more for your money at Sunset Subaru in Sarasota. Subaru is rated the number one car brand in safety, and all Subaru models with EyeSight are a 2017 IIHS top safety pick. And you can lease the most award-winning small SUV, a new Subaru Forester, for just $209 a month. Or get 0% financing with complimentary maintenance included. Get more for your money. Go to Sunset Subaru in Sarasota.
Since 2004, Embracing Our Differences has used the power of art and education to promote diversity. One way it accomplishes this is through its annual outdoor exhibition of 45 billboard-sized works of art, each accompanied by an inspirational quote. Join us in creating a community that is inclusive for all, where differences are embraced and individuality is celebrated. We invite you to celebrate the voices and visions of diversity and inclusion at this year's exhibit at Sarasota's Island Park.
For your plumbing, electrical, or air conditioning, and services is qualified, and service calls are free, and services.com, A-N-D, services.com.
Coronary temperatures coming in at a toasty 80 degrees. Dew points are low, still at 53, making it feel pretty comfortable outside, despite the fact that we have above average temperatures. A lot of sunshine, and as Jacqueline rightly mentioned and reminded us all, sunscreen required if you're going to be at the beach this weekend. We'll have a lot of blue sky out there, so a lot of reflected UV, A and B. A lot of cloud cover building in inland areas, but not so much near the coast. Dew points. Now, these are dew point numbers. These are not air temperatures, obviously. Dew point values, how much moisture there is in the air. And if you look to the north, they're in the 50s. To the east, they're in the 50s. To the south, they're basically in the 50s. So no matter which direction out of the east the winds come, northeast, southeast, east, you're getting dry air moving into our area. So the bottom line there is we are in for a lovely weekend because we are going to consistently have this easterly wind flow, and that means dry air, low humidity air in place right straight through the weekend. Good news here from Moat Marine. They issued their spotter reports from these various area beaches looking for the amount of red tide irritants that are in the air. And none of them show any irritants, according to the observation site and the time that they were taken. Plus, the state of Florida has released their report on the amount of red tide in the water a little bit early, and it comes up pretty clear. Everywhere you look across our area waterways, the red tide concentrations are either very low or non-existent, except for a few places. Coon Key, Centennial Island, City Island have moderate red tide amounts in the water. But it doesn't appear to be transferring into the air, and the easterly wind flow will continue. Trajectories over the next 3 days continue to show the red tide moving further and further away from land. So good news if you're going to be out there at the beaches this weekend. We're looking at quiet conditions on radar. Maybe a few scattered showers down here will develop around the mouth of Charlotte Harbor later today, but it's really no big deal. Deep south looks good if you're traveling to our airport hubs. That should not be an issue. You got to go back to the west to find any kind of building shower activity, and it is there that you might actually see some severe weather because of this frontal boundary, which continues to press eastward. Now, as it does that, this high sinks south and into the Atlantic, twisting our winds around to the east and strengthening them a little bit. So boaters, use some caution out there a little bit later on today. We may actually have an exercise caution statement or even a marine warning out, small craft advisory, for our area waters tonight or tomorrow because those wind speeds will be increasing, kind of surging. So sunny skies, breezy winds, especially in the evenings, and then dry into next week. Now, if you get up tomorrow morning and those winds aren't strong, don't let it fool you. They will die down toward morning, and they'll increase again toward the late evening and into the overnight. Temperatures through the weekend in the mid-80s, and then as we head into late next week, we'll start to think about a rain chance again. Back to you, Jacqueline.
All right, thanks so much, John. Well, it's a busy weekend for the Suncoast as many people are celebrating Easter. Now, there are plenty of special events to keep everyone entertained. ABC 7's Linda Carson has more in your Suncoast scene.
The Suncoast Barbecue and Bluegrass Bash rolls into Venice this weekend. Some of the top barbecue teams in the Southeast will be here to compete. The barbecue judging is Saturday. The festival starts Friday at 5 p.m.
And we have a band, and the beer garden's going to be open, and our vendors are going to be selling barbecue.
Then Saturday, we open up at 10 o'clock. We have 50 barbecue teams that will be here competing for awards and prizes. And we have about 20 vendors that are selling their barbecue here.
And there's a great lineup of bands.
Swingin' Bridge is going to be here Friday night. And then we have three of the top bluegrass bands in the country that will be here Saturday afternoon.
Those bands are the Boxcars, the Grascals, and the Lonesome River Band. Near the end of the festival, all the bands will come together for a wild jam session.
The Suncoast Barbecue and Bluegrass Bash at the Venice Airport Festival Grounds, Friday night from 5 to 9 and Saturday 10 to 6.
And the Circus Arts Conservatory presents the Sailor Circus Spring Show.
Sailor Circus celebrates 68 years with Once Upon a Circus. You will not believe what these young ladies can do.
My sister and I both actually do a forward roll, which is pretty cool together.
Where do you do that?
On the high wire. We roll across the high wire. Well, she does a headstand too. She doesn't like to brag about that, but it's really impressive. And we walk a pyramid together, so a three-person pyramid where there's the two of us with a shoulder bar and someone stands on top of it. And then other acts, I do slack rope and also acrobatic roller skating.
There are more than 100 Suncoast students from 8 to 18 in the show. Performances are at 7 p.m. tonight through Saturday night with a Saturday matinee at 2. It's under the big top at Bella Vista and US 41.
And the My Hometown Fest, sponsored by the Sutomas, is going to be here at Nathan Benderson Park on Saturday. There'll be great music. Twinkle's going to be here.
We're going to have 40 different restaurants out serving regional specialties. We've got 60 craft beers from Gold Coast Eagle Distributing. We have great live music with Twinkle and Rock Soul Radio, Reverend Barry and Funktastic Soul. And we've got all sorts of fun activities for families and kids.
From Nathan Benderson Park, Linda Carson, ABC 7, your Suncoast News.
All sorts of fun things to do here on the Suncoast this weekend. Well, the Hermitage is an artist retreat nestled in a historic section of Manasota Beach. And beginning next Thursday, a series of events are planned in celebration of the awarding of the Greenfield Prize, which is awarded every year to one artist. John Scalzi is joined with a special guest from the Hermitage. John?
Indeed, I am. Jacqueline, Executive Director Bruce Rogers. Good to have you here, sir.
Great to be here, John. Thank you.
So because it's a retreat, I guess not everybody has heard of the artist retreat, the Hermitage. Tell us a little bit about what it is.
Well, we bring writers, painters, poets, composers, playwrights. They come from around the world, and they do their work in our studios, and they live there in the living spaces that we've created there.
It's an exceptional environment, and the people that come are chosen by internationally renowned panel of experts across the country, right?
Exactly. By invitation only. And in return for being there, they do free programs for the community,
these
wonderful people.
Which brings us to the point of our conversation here today. So next Friday, you have a couple of special artists that will be performing, and we're looking at some of the work of one of your artists who will be giving free talks, right? Conversations.
That is the work of David Burnett, who won the Greenfield Prize this year. And he will be commissioned. He's won a $30,000 prize, and he'll be commissioned for a whole new body of work, which in 2 years will be premiered at the Sarasota Museum of Art. So I'll be back in two years talking about his work that we can all go and
see. That is exceptional. It's beautiful work that he's doing there. So he's one of the people that, for free, you will hear him talk about his work and converse.
For free on Sunday. That's on Sunday afternoon at 2 o'clock.
Next Sunday afternoon.
Yes. Yeah. And he's going to talk about his career at 2 o'clock, and there'll be a panel of experts, photography experts, talking about his work and photography in general at 3:15.
Awesome. Now, you also have some other artist that is going to be discussing his work and his group's work.
The winner 2 years ago, Bobby Previtt, he won his $30,000 prize, and that's having its world premiere in conjunction with New Music, New College. And it starts actually with a talk with Bobby and his band on Thursday night, free, at the Saner Pavilion at New College.
And tell us about that email, by the way, that you got.
We got an email from the London Jazz Times saying, wow, what a band, lucky Sarasota.
That's pretty cool. That's pretty cool. So, I'm sorry, tell us again, the times are going to be a
And so the Concert Times, the world premiere of his piece called Terminals in Transit, is on Friday night at 8 o'clock, and that's $15.
Great.
And then Saturday afternoon at 3 o'clock. also be replayed again.
And they've already got a recording contract for
They already have a recording contract for the piece. It's a world-class band that's going to be playing.
And then if you want to attend the big dinner, the tickets are also available for that.
They
help support the Hermitage Artists Retreat.
Saturday night,
good work.
You'll get to meet David Burnett, and you'll get to learn all about his work. He's been photographed and photographing all the presidents since John Kennedy, all the Olympics since 1986, 78 countries he's worked in. He's an amazing journalist, photojournalist, who's won this $30,000 prize.
For more information, do you have a website?
We do, greenfieldprize.org.
There you go. Thanks so much for coming in today.
Thanks
this sounds like
us.
A wonderful event. I can't wait to hear the concert. That's going to be awesome. $50, can't beat that, right? We'll be right back.
Sarasota Magazine and PNC Wealth Management present the Best of Sarasota Soiree at Selby Gardens on April 24th.
It's an evening to sip, savor, and celebrate Sarasota Manatee's Best of Winners.
This year will be full of Warhol-inspired surprises, entertainment, and a tribute to those representing the best in our community.
Come join ABC7 for all the fun.
Get your tickets today at sarasotamagazine.com.
ABC 7 News at 7, weeknights.
I was always worried and scared. Mom was in pain. She wasn't going to get any better, and all the trips to the ER were painful for all of us. Then we called Tidewell Hospice, and everything changed. Now she has care in our home when she needs it, surrounded by family. We know we don't have much time left with Mom, but we decided to make the best out of that time. Tidewell Hospice, it's more than you think.
Hi, I'm Chef Judy. Every Wednesday morning, I'll be with the chefs at the Publix Aprons Cooking School serving up the most wonderful dishes. Watch Aprons in the Kitchen every Wednesday on ABC7's Good Morning Suncoast.
Since 1972, Sleep King has provided quality mattresses and accessories at the best discounted prices available. Top brands like Simmons, Sealy, Serta, Beautyrest, iComfort, and more. With available free delivery, free financing, and free setup and removal. For a comfortable night's sleep with same-day delivery, even if we have to carry it on our backs. Trust Sleep King of Sarasota. Buy it today, sleep on it tonight.
There are many choices when it comes to AC companies. Our advice? Choose a company that performs employee background checks and is licensed with top manufacturers like Daikin. Daikin offers a 12-year parts and labor limited warranty. For better comfort and value, call Elite Heating and Air.
Need more space in your place? The More Space Place can help. With Murphy beds that disappear to reveal a home office, living room, or den. Custom closets with designated areas for your shoes, bags, wardrobe, and accessories. Custom-built entertainment centers, garage storage systems, and more. The More Space Place has three showrooms. Next to Sonny's on US 41 South in Sarasota, on Lakewood Ranch Boulevard just south of State Route 64 in Bradenton, and on Tamiami Trail next to Panera Bread in Port Charlotte. Put more space in your place at the More Space Place.
Outdoor living is one of the greatest perks about living in Florida. So whether this is your style or this, or maybe this, contact Superior Pools. They've been building pools from Sarasota to Naples since 2001, and they would love to build yours.
It has been such a beautiful day here, right at the Bread Box French cuisine at its best at Selby Gardens. You're going to enjoy the Chagall exhibit and the beautiful lavender fields. And make sure besides lunch, you finish up with whether it's tartine or a macadamia nut tart, that beautiful chocolate banana bread we talked about. And look at this. These are banana Nutella crepes made fresh. It is going to be the most delicious experience. Little splits of champagne and iced tea. So much going on here. So I want to wish everybody a very special Happy Passover and happy Easter. No matter what you decide to do, I hope it's delicious, but definitely put Selby Gardens and the French food truck on your radar soon. I'm going to tuck into this and send it back to you, Jacqueline. Bon appetit.
Oh man, that looks delicious. Thank you so much, Chef Judy. Well, Eli Manning is reportedly being accused of taking part in an alleged scheme to sell falsely labeled New York Giants gear. The legal filing was made Thursday in New Jersey. It's part of a civil racketeering lawsuit against Manning, the Giants, and other team employees. Now, according to the New York Post, court documents claim that the NFL quarterback sent an email to the Giants equipment manager asking for helmets that can pass as game used. Reportedly, another alleged email claims Manning wanted to send fake memorabilia because he did not want to give up the real stuff. Manning nor the Giants have responded to those allegations. Well, Star Wars fans are making the jump to hyperspace and setting course in Orlando. It's all in part of the commemoration of the 40th anniversary of one of the biggest film franchises and pop culture influences in history. Some 50,000 fans are expected to attend wearing their favorite Star Wars costumes. People will come from all across the nation to attend. That big conference lasts through the weekend at the Orange County Convention Center. John, will you be heading out there in your Star Wars gear?
I tell you what,
and Yoda's costume.
Yeah, I know, right? There's a part of me that, you know, would really enjoy that, and a part of me that's a little weirded out that I would really enjoy that.
A part of me would just personally enjoy seeing you in that costume.
Yeah, right. Jaja Banks, that would be good.
All right, thanks for watching your news at noon. We'll see you back here on ABC 7 this evening.
I'm calling in regards about my mother, and I'm here, and I just want to thank you because it saved my mother's life yesterday. And I'd like to know the names of the people that came in and saved her so I could call and thank them. And she's doing fine. It's a wonderful thing. Thank you.
When you fall and cannot get up, an accident can turn into a tragedy. But with Life Alert, one touch of a button can get you help fast. Life Alert saves a person from a catastrophe every 10 minutes.
Life Alert is a lifesaver. If it weren't for Life Alert, I wouldn't be sitting here today.
For a free Life Alert brochure, call 1-800-962-4112. That's 1-800-962-4112. Call now, 1-800-962-4112. For a free brochure, call 1-800-962-4112.